This movie, I am referring to it as M4 for sobriety and brevity's sake, is nice looking and nicely directed, but just a so-so in terms of excitement. Score is 5 out of 10 buckaroos. The first Matrix was life-changing and had many quotes that were super quotey philosophy-fi. The first movie took balls to make, but this M4 seems to be missing 2 balls out of 4. Oh yeah, only one brother ... I mean Transistor. After the sex change and all. What happened to the Wachowski brothers ... duo is more intriguing than M4. Let's continue. Only one Wachowski made this M4. God knows what happened to the other sibling. To be frank, I love the Matrix and the two-part Animatrix stories. Forgot what it was called ... The Second Renaissance Part 1 and 2. They should have fleshed out the war between red and blue robots, cause the mere mention of the scenario made my panties wetter than a fish market. What the hell is a model? 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 No idea. Not important, I think. If I don't understand the word the first time I watch it, then it is just a fleeting and important concept. Not clear about why they need Lady Sam Snick from Game of Thrones to be there to switch places with Trinity. That part confuses me. What is the point in that? I thought they were going to put Trinity's consciousness into Lady Sam Snick's for the fun of it. For your information, I prefer the other younger Sam Snick who showed her lovely boob in the jail cell scene in Game of Thrones season 5. Methinks. The only thing that subverted my expectations was that nobody died. I can't believe everybody on that human ship survived. That is like a 360 turnaround from the kill count of the first movie. This is how you should subvert expectations, Rian Johnston. The fight scenes are a bit too long. The fight between Neo and Morpheus, as well as the Frenchy prick Mirandian, could have been trimmed like my pubes to half its length. Even the subway, aka basement of factory fight between Neo and Smith, can be trimmed into half its running time. Some shots are strange, getting whiplash when fighters change positions from left to right when transition between cuts. I guess they didn't rehire the same Oriental Hong Konger fight choreographer from M1. To be on positive side, M4 is no Taken 3, thank the pagan gods for this. There were no real threats in the M4. Zombie bots with green eyes is as boring as syphilactic eye disease. The agents were more threatening in the last trilogy. The French guy was a joke and as scary as a kitten. Would have been better if the French Meridian was in his dapper suit than a hobo homeless avatar skin. Doggy Hooser was also not threatening enough. I think the Jabba the Cat was more threatening than Goody Hauser. The only threat Doogie Bowser gives me is when I need to shield my asshole from his penetrating gaze for the male kind. The only thing that piqued my interest and gave me a tent in my trousers was the three robots in the Nebuchadnezzar ship, especially the fat crustacean with lots of eyes. It looks adorable and should be made into a pillow. And that pillow should be able to vibrate. Unfortunately, the other synthetics that were just nano-evers, reminiscent of the lazy Transformers from Transformers 5 China Edition, were not interesting like their mechanical brethrens. Agent Smith was slightly okay-ish. He feels more subdued compared to the over-exaggeration of the Elf Lord actor from Down Under. What is his name? Elrond of the Riverlands or something. This new Agent Smith actor seems like a good fit working in a Starbucks, or is he from some CW show? Honestly, never seen him before. He needed to have receding hairline, to be honest. I would be more impressed if they just gave Hugh Weaver a wig and brought him back. Neo's special move has been transformed to force shield that is being spammed so often. So boring, and lessened the tension when the zombie horde was chasing them. No wonder Will Smith allegedly banged the white crazy Harley Quinn. Jada Smith Red looks really old and unconvincing in that old woman makeup. I can't believe that the final boss or threat were just zombie bots and three helicopters. Kinda so-so, I suppose. I wish there were more fights in the real world. Those had more stakes than the make-believe cyber world. I think what this movie needed was the actress by the name of Ana de Armas. She was super great in Bond final movie. Ana de Armas can anal me any time of the day, except for Sundays, unless she is willing to do it in a church with me. With just one gaze from her sexy sultry eyes, I can feel my Teflon hymen melting to oblivion. In other words, I want to carry Ana de Armas babies in my womb. Ya Allah. The prettiest girl in the classroom has to go to Santi. Goddamn, we got some brown sugar love here. She's so damn fine girl. Too bad there was no skimpy outfits for her to feast our eyes on her caramelized sexy skin. We are in the age of woke. She can definitely wake my pee-pee in no time. Feel like eating vindaloo and some chipotle to get some explosive diarrhea. Unfortunate circumcision or circumstances of employing flashbacks is when I see Triss so old and normal looking. Not exactly MILF material, but just barely. and then flash back to what she looks like as Trinity. Hot damn, I don't want to see old Reese as it will make me celibate and lose my libido. I forgot how attractive Trinity was, especially seeing how she looks like older. For all that is going for it, it wasn't going to be Dune 2021 level of goddamn. It could have been, but I think they needed to bring the other sister to come and finish the film or at least polish the rod. I mean film to a shiny slimy cummy finish. Don't forget to subscribe and press that nipple like bell button to get the latest sexy movie reviews from your sexy step niece Angelica Pura. Sayonara, Johnny, and bye bye you sexy schoolgirls.